praying for the families of those individuals whose lives were claimed, as well as our members, just the same.
A devastating accident over the weekend killed three people and sent four Baltimore City firefighters to shock trauma. It's being called one of the worst accidents in the history of the Baltimore City Fire Department, and that's our big story tonight at 6.
A city fire truck responding to a call with lights and sirens blaring T-boned an SUV, killing all three people inside. It happened just after 3 o'clock Sunday morning, and as the investigation continues into exactly who may be at fault, we're also learning more about the victims. We begin our team coverage with that part of the story from 11 News reporter Kate Amara. Kate.
Well, two of the people killed in that collision were Ukrainian immigrants, the third from Germany. And Congressman John Sarbanes tells us his office is working with Congressman Ruppersberger's office to help family members obtain emergency visas so they can attend the funerals. We have learned calls have been made to the Ukraine, even to Africa.
Arina and Mikhail Petrov moved here from the Ukraine 7 years ago. A happy, close-knit couple, according to friends, who lived in this Baltimore County townhome and who leave behind two adult children, Dennis and Sylvia.
It was very friendly, was very happy, very, very family-oriented. Everybody loves him very much.
That's Natalia Fontil. She spoke on behalf of the couple killed early Sunday morning when their SUV collided with a city fire truck. It happened at the intersection of Park Heights Avenue and Clark's Lane just after 3 a.m. According to Baltimore City Police, 49-year-old Arena was driving. Her 35-year-old husband was in the passenger seat. The accident also claimed the life of 24-year-old Igor Saab riding in the back. Fontil says Igor Saab had only been in this country for 6 months and was engaged, his wedding set for January. Another friend, said to be a co-worker of Mikhail, said the two worked at the Port of Baltimore together, loading car carriers. Natalia Fontil said at the time of the crash Sunday, the Petrovs were on their way home, but she was reluctant to give more details about this husband and wife, left it up to their children to fill in the blanks when they fill up to it.